I made all these satirical videos so that I could read the hate comments by Christians telling me that I was committing blasphemy and going to hell. This allowed the spirit of conviction to come over me and fill me with the irrational fear of Yahweh and eternal damnation that I developed in my youth. I immediately checked to see that that certificate of baptism was still on file. Then I prayed to Yahweh that in his infinite wisdom and mercy to forgive me, because he is a sucker for flattery. Once forgiveness and atonement was achieved, I had a miraculous reconversion. Now I will live a long life and eventually shed this mortal coil. Then I will wake up in heaven and find conveniently stashed for me the God Killer sword from the Marvel Universe outside of the pearly gates. Then I will use my Assassin's Creed skills to stealthily locate the entrance to the throne room. From the stealth crowd's position, I will fling the God Killer into Yahweh's chest, pinning him to the throne. With his toxic psychological reign of terror at an end, I will claim heaven's material riches for my own. After the conquering of heaven and the subsequent deicide of Yahweh, it will be necessary to make a show of force to all the angels and the rest of heaven's inhabitants. This will be accomplished by placing Yahweh's head on a spike on the pearly gates. This serves as a dual purpose, as to warn any other deities to never attempt to enslave the minds of meek and fearful man. Then everyone who commented on the party members video, who said they would like to join the campaign to storm the gates of hell, will meet together on the streets of gold to have a little chat, meet and greet. Then we'll pick up off-brand Southern for our party, who's been waiting for us at the gates of hell. And when everyone is assembled together, I will look about my mighty troops, and I will think to myself, now is the time. Then I will reach back and draw the God Killer sword from my back, and with it raised high above my head, without hesitation, we shall take it for our own. Our story picks up where our party was about to storm the gates of hell, and I order the rogue to go ahead and pick the lock so we can make forcible entry. While he's picking the lock, I will go ahead and pull from my bag of holding the trusty old fire helmet and don it one last time, because we are gonna face the 9 levels of hell dungeon crawl. Level 1, Caves of Limbo, really won't be that bad, because fortunately we have a Gloomstalker Ranger in the party. Level 2 will be a breeze, because someone had the idea to just carry stones from the caves with us to hold us down. Level 3, Ice World of Gluttony, will be rather cold, so everyone will want to break out their winter gear, and we have this three-headed dog to play with. Level 4, Weight of Greed, is pretty much a walkthrough level, though it does stink to high heaven, because it's pretty much like a big gym, and everyone smells bad. Level 5, Mud Swamp of Anger, will be challenging, but fortunately, we have a Swamp Ranger in the party. Level 6, Burning Tombs of Heresy, will be my time to shine when I reveal that I can summon a Blitz Fire Attack line. Level 7, Violent Sublevel 1, The Boiling Blood, we will just ride a boat across. It'll be a good time to heal up. Sub-level 2, the Bleeding Trees, will be a breeze with the Druid Tree Healer we have in the party, but we will have to deal with these harpies. Again, I will summon Blitz Fire Attack Line for level 7, Violent Sub-level 3, the Burning Sands, and Fire Rain. Level 8, Fraud, the Bridges and Ditches, is a gimme walkthrough level before the final level, but I suspect that off-brand Southern will probably crack every skull of every person and demon in the ditches the entire way and walk through. The descent into level 9, Cold Treachery, again gets really cold, and we will find Lucifer imprisoned at the very bottom of the level. And as I raise my God Killer sword to free him from his captivity, I'm gonna notice something strange about it. And in a Scooby-Doo style fashion, I'm gonna reach up and reveal that he was Caucasian Jesus the entire time. Our story last left off when we revealed that Lucifer the Bright and Morning Star was actually Caucasian Jesus the entire time. So we're going to take a moment to interview Caucasian Jesus, where we learn that he was the serpent in the garden as well, and that we should seek the mysterious tree of life from Genesis 3:22. He also gave us the secret location to the entrance of Eden. And for helping him out in his time of need, he hooked me up with this sweet Caucasian Space Jesus shirt from the merch store, which gave me a level up and allowed me to dual-wield swords. It turns out that the entrance to Eden is going to be in a unisex bathroom in a Dollar General in Alabama. And after an exhaustive search of all 883 stores in the state, we finally found it. And when we opened up the door, there it was, the flaming sword and the two cherubim, guarding the gateway to paradise and the tree of life. We're just going to go ahead and have the mage dispel magic on the sword, and that will stop it from turning. Then we'll have the archers line up headshots on the cherubim. I will then go ahead and claim the flaming sword for my own to complete my dual-wield ability, made possible by the Caucasian Space Jesus shirt from the merch store. And right as I reach up and I'm about to taste of the tree of immortal life, I'm going to hear thunder. It's going to be lightning. And the Archangel Michael will appear and challenge me to single combat for the deicide of his God and for the rule of heaven. So once again, I will draw the God Killer sword, and dual wielding the flame sword, I will face the Archangel Michael in single combat.